Truth faith, we may acknowledge the Trinity of eternal glory and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. With the two tablets of stone in his hands, Moses went up the mountain of Sinai in the early morning as the Lord had commanded him. And the Lord descended in the form of a cloud, and Moses stood with him there. He called on the name of the Lord. The Lord passed before him and proclaimed, "Lord, Lord, a God of tenderness and compassion, slow to anger, rich in kindness and faithfulness." And Moses bowed down to the ground at once and worshipped. "If I have indeed won your favor, Lord," he said, "let my Lord come with us, I beg. True, they are a headstrong people, but forgive us our faults and our sins, and adopt us as your heritage." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be
to God. To you glory and praise forevermore. You are blessed, Lord God of our fathers, blessed your glorious holy name. You are blessed in the temple of your glory, you are blessed on the throne of your kingdom. You are blessed who gaze into the depths, you are blessed in the firmament of heaven. A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers, we wish you happiness. Try to grow perfect. Help one another. Be united. Live in peace. And the God of love and peace will be with you. Greet one another with the holy kiss. All the saints send you greetings. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. The word of the Lord.
Alleluia.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, the God who is, who was, and who is to come.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to Nicodemus, "God loved the world so much that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not be lost, but may have eternal life. For God sent his Son into the world, not to condemn the world, but so that through him the world might be saved. No one who believes in him will be condemned. But whoever refuses to believe is condemned already, because he has refused to believe in the name of God's only Son." The Gospel of the Lord. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The great explorer Christopher Columbus had a deep devotion to the Holy Trinity. He invoked the Trinity at the beginning of every enterprise, and everything he wrote began with the words, "In the name of the Most Holy Trinity." On his third voyage in 1598, he vowed to consecrate the Trinity, the first land that he would discover. And so the island he reached was called Trinidad. There is a beautiful Russian icon of the Blessed Trinity, painted by a monk called Rublev. It depicts the three divine persons sitting at a table. A dish of food lies on the table. But the thing that immediately strikes you is the fact that at the front of the table there is a vacant place. The vacant place is meant to convey openness, hospitality, and welcome towards the stranger and outsider. This vacant place is meant for each of us and for the whole human family. It signifies God's invitation to us to share in the life of the Trinity. God doesn't exclude us, and he doesn't do social distancing. He invites us to come in and sit at his table. He wants to share his life with us. In the words of the Gospel, God loved the world so much that he gave his only Son. Many are put off by the great mystery of the Blessed Trinity, and that's a pity. We should see the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit as friends to whom we can relate and to whom we can turn in prayer. Because God's Son, Jesus, befriended us, we are no longer strangers or outsiders. We are God's children. We are part of the family. He has already given us a place at the banquet of earthly life, but he wants us to save a place at the banquet of eternal life too. Only at God's table can we find the nourishment our hearts are longing for. From all this we see that God is a God of love. Our response can only be one of trust in God and love towards one another. What St. Paul said to the Corinthians is meant for us too. Help one another, be united, live in peace, and the God of love and peace will be with you. Amen. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Jesus told Nicodemus that the reason he came into the world was because of the infinite love of God for all peoples. With confidence in his love for us, we make our prayers.
For church leaders, priests, deacons, and religious, that in leading people into the heart of the mystery of God's mercy and graciousness, we may all become steadfast in love and faithfulness. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For people who have been persecuted because of their faith, and those living in violent and war-torn parts of the world, that they may be supported by the peace, love, grace, and fellowship that God offers us through one another and in his word. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For poets, artists, writers, and all who give us a glimpse of the mystery of God through their work, that their inspiration and creativity may open new horizons for all peoples to live life to the full. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For vocations, that God who sent his Son into the world to proclaim his word and bring us to eternal life may so inspire young men and women to give their lives to follow him in the priesthood and religious life. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For the sick and those afflicted in any way, we pray especially for those affected by the coronavirus, that they may unite their cross with the suffering of Christ and find new life and strength each day. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
And we pray for all our own intentions. Lord, hear us. And we pray for all who have died. The recently deceased, Dolores O'Connor, late of London, formerly of Portadown, Alice McCann, Dimpna Mullen, and Albina Gajuskienė of Lithuania. And at this time, remember James McDowell, Patrick Toland, Alice Toland, and Annie McVeigh. Saturday is the anniversaries of William Atkinson, Paddy Cullen, Eileen McNeice, and Ellen Caldwell. And tomorrow, Sunday, the anniversaries of May McNeice and Mary Lappin. May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Let us pray. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we give you thanks on this, the feast of the Holy Trinity, for the immense love God offers each one of us. We make our prayer spoken and unspoken, confident that God will give us the blessings we really need to live in his presence through Christ our Lord. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Sanctified by the invocation of your name, we pray, O Lord, this oblation of our service, and by it make of us an eternal offering to you, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For with your only begotten Son and the Holy Spirit, you are one God, one Lord, not in the unity of a single person, but in the Trinity of one substance. For what you have revealed to us of your glory, we believe equally of your Son and of the Holy Spirit, so that in the confessing of the true and eternal Godhead, you might be adored in what is proper to each person, their unity in substance, and their equality in majesty. For this is praised by angels and archangels, cherubim too, and seraphim, who never cease to cry out each day, as with one voice they acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Eamon our Bishop, his assistant Bishop Michael, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Joseph, our venerable spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. At the Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God. Pray. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Remember, O most gracious Virgin Mary, that never was it known that anyone who fled to your protection, implored your help, or sought your intercession was left unaided. Inspired with this confidence, I fly unto you, O Virgin of Virgins, my Mother. To you I come, before you I stand, sinful and sorrowful. O Mother of the Word incarnate, despise not my petitions, but in your mercy hear and answer. Amen. Let us pray. May receiving this sacrament, O Lord our God, bring us health of body and soul, as we confess your eternal Holy Trinity and undivided unity, through Christ our Lord. And just a few notices. Last week's collection amounted to £1,603.14, and thank you to all who contributed. And in light of the current situation, there have been a lot of inquiries from parishioners wishing to continue support our parish financially during these times. And to facilitate this, parishioners are advised to leave their weekly envelope in the parish office letterbox, the letterbox of either parochial house, or in the red box in St. John the Baptist Church, where they will be picked up each day. And the Drumcree Parish Draw, the committee has agreed that the monthly draws for March, April and May will take place in the parish pastoral centre immediately after the Vigil Mass on Saturday the 20th of June. That's next Saturday. And due to the restrictions, proceedings will be broadcast live on the parish Facebook page and uploaded later to YouTube. And the June draw will take place in the parish pastoral centre immediately after the Vigil Mass on Saturday. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Wash your hands.
Holy God, we pray.